Hello all. Today we will talk about the mesh terms. Mesh term is standing for medical subject heading, and it is used by NLM control vocabulary reads used for indexing article for PubMed. These mean it is the set of controlled vocabulary terms used by NLM for describing article and papers in PubMed. It is actually allows people to use one type of vocabulary or one words to describe the synonymous terms when searching in PubMed. So, all papers describing the same things can be linked together. So, it is very important to look up for mesh terms in order to run more specific search in PubMed. The reason for this, it is might be use a term that is very specific or too broad. Also, they are the synonymous that reduce the result when searching for one of specific terms in PubMed. And what the mesh database allowed to do is to look up these terms and synonymous and indexing them. So let's do some tutorial. To reach the mesh terms interface, firstly go to NCBI homepage. And on the drop-down menu of database, you will find the mesh. Here is mesh database. If it is not appeared here, then you have to go to popular resource. If it is not appeared even in popular resource, then you go to resource list. So let's begin. Here is mesh database. I choose it. And if you leave the search part here empty, it will direct you to mesh homepage. Taken the term that I have using before called speech development. Then I get back these two items. The term we look for is language development disorder. So in the mesh database, the term speech development or all the terms that link it to the speech development are contained in a broad term called language development disorder in mesh terms or in CBI. If I click in this term, well, and if you scroll down to the bottom of the page, you will find the set of three structure from more broadly term here, the more broadly term in the upside, and down to the more specific term here. And what you found here in the bottom is one of the term of the language development disorder here. So in the mesh database, the speech development is actually referred to as language development disorder. And you see below that specific language disorder, and if you click on the on that, it will giving you terms that use specifically the specific language disorder. So what we can try to do now is instead of using speech development, we have to use the mesh term language development disorder. So that is what I have done here before in PubMed. And if you want to know how I gained this information, then you have to go to the previous video for PubMed searching, advanced PubMed searching. So what we can try to do now is instead of using speech development, we have to use the mesh term language development disorder, and even you can specify it in title and abstract. So that is what I have done here before. Here is the mutation and FOXP2 gene speech development, and here is the Boolean mutation and speech development and FOXP2. It gained 93 hits, and here is the specification. Mutation with title abstract and speech development title abstract and E, and finally FOXP2 with title abstract. It gives only three hits. Then I search FOXP2 title abstract, and here instead of using speech development, I use this time language development disordered in according to mesh term and mutation. Then it gives zero result. Again, I use speech development in title abstract and FOXP2. Here I use speech development. I gain 16 hits. Again, I use language development disorder with FOXP2 like this choice here, and again only zero result. And what we see now is number of hits is decreased dramatically, and the reason for that is fact that the speech development phrase I was used here may have too broad and doesn't used in mesh database to describe less arrays of speech development disorder or a specific disorder in mesh terms or in mesh database. Here it must be useful to know that if you use the term that doesn't recognize by NCBI, or you use the terms that have a match in mesh database, in most instances it will automatically pull the mesh database terms and use it as the search query as well. But it is not do that as efficiently as it should be if you actually put the mesh terms when you are searching for medical cases. Good wishes and regards for your advancing literature searching in NCBI, and goodbye for today.